Hey, this is Kev with Blender Binge, back with another video. This time we're going to be creating this cool stringy, energy, metallic, cool spaghetti style animated logo that appears and does some cool stuff. So let's just jump in. The first thing I'm going to do is create some text. So I'm just going to go add text, and you see it says text. Wonderful. So I'm going to just change this to logo. So I'm going to hit tab. And I'm just going to spell the word logo, because I don't know, why not, right? Logo. And I think I'm going to go to this little A down here, and I'm going to change the font. So I'm going to go to font, regular here, and I'll just choose a new font. So I'm in my fonts folder, and I think I'll just go and grab, I have one in mind, let me see. Luckiest guy. Nice and thick, and it works for this tutorial. Okay. So that's great, done. So now what I'm gonna do is I'm going to convert this text, okay? It looks how I want it. I'm assuming it's gonna look how you want it. I'm gonna convert text, object, convert to mesh from curve, whatever. And then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna hit tab. I'm gonna hit A to select everything. I'll go to faces here, all right? A to select everything. I'm gonna hit E on the keyboard once, then I'm gonna hit enter. And then I'm going to go to the Move tool and pull it up. Make it thick, kind of thick. That's probably pretty good, like that. Okay, then hit Tab again. And now I could have used the thickness inside the font thing, but it's not gonna work very well for this next step I wanna do, because it's gonna separate these polygons and you have to go and clean it up. So this way is much easier. So now what I can do is I can just hit Tab again, hit A, select everything, and then I'm just gonna go to Mesh, Separate by Loose Parts. And what that does is I hit Tab again, now I have separate objects. Okay, text one, text two, text three, whatever. So the next stage is, I could have just done this before too, but I'm just gonna rotate these guys up. So let's see here. I can open up this little tab here, and I can go to Item, and I'll just hit 90 degrees on the X. So now it's standing up, and then I can kind of move it into the middle. Right? It doesn't have to be perfect, just kind of like right there. That's pretty good. So now the next thing we want to do is enable the Magic plugin. The Magic plugin exists inside Blender 2.8, and I believe this has been here for a while, but if you go to Edit, Preferences, and you type in Add Curve, okay, or you just scroll down here where it says Add Curve Extra Objects, okay, you turn that on, and you get this little Create tab over here. Go to Create, and now for each one of these, I can hit Bounce Spline, and it gives me spline. And then I have this Bounce Spline thing down here where I can go ahead and kind of choose how I want, how many splines I want. And that's probably pretty good right there. And for each one of these, I can do the same thing. Bounce spline and bounce spline. And now what I can do is I can just go and hide these other little texts, and now I have the magic. So from here, what I can do is select this, and I can go to this little object data, go to geometry, and just give it a depth of like 0.0, that's way too big. 0.005. That's probably pretty good right there. Same thing with this, depth 0.005. Here, depth 0.005. And the reason I'm doing this separately is because some of them might not look as good, so I'm just gonna do this one at a time, 0.005. And that's kinda cool. I like that. So now what I can do is just give this a floor. So I'll hit Add, Mesh, Plane. I don't know, 50, make it nice and huge, and that's kind of cool. All right, so I have this, and I have this. Okay, so we have the floor, and we have the logo, and now I'm just going to animate the camera a little bit. So what I'm gonna do is select the camera. Here's my camera, and I think I'll zero it out first. So I'll hit Alt-R and Alt-G. And then I'll pull it back a little bit here. Maybe pull it up. And with our item and rotate it like 90 degrees. That's probably pretty good. And then what I think I'm going to do is I'm actually going to create an empty that it can stare at. So I'm going to go add empty plane axis. And the plane axis is just a non-rendering object. It doesn't render. It's just something I can use a camera to point at. So if I select the camera and I go over here to constraints, I say add object constraint, and I say track 2. And then I'm going to choose the target being the empty, and I'll say negative Z, and I'll choose up axis is Y. And now you'll see if I move this around, the camera tracks to it. So what I'll do is I'll hit 0, and I just want to get a little bit of a camera motion in here. So I think this animation will be about 144 frames. So I'll go in there and type in 144. And if I scale this up a little bit here, you can see this now. I have 1 to 144. So at 1, oops, 0, let me go to view and turn on lock camera to view. And what that does is it allows me to just navigate using the camera. It's like I'm holding the camera. So I'm going to middle mouse out about here. And what I'll do is I'll go to camera, item, and in the location, I don't need to worry about rotation because the rotation is handled by the aiming of the aiming on the empty. So I'll just go in here and hit insert keyframes. And then I'll go to 144. Maybe I'll zoom it over. I'll just middle mouse over here, about there, and hit insert keyframes. So now I have two diamonds on the timeline. And if I hit play, you could see that I am now have a nice kind of sweeping motion here. Okay, and I'll leave it at that. And what I'll do now is I'll start getting the look. So to do that, first let me save. I'm gonna pause the video and save this and come back. Okay, so I saved it. And what I'll do now is I like having the timeline here. Now I'm in Blender 2.8, so I could use these workspaces up here for shading, but I like having the timeline here and everything. So I'm just gonna go ahead down here where my mouse becomes a little crosshair, drag up, and I'm gonna change this to shader editor. So I will select this guy and I'll hit new. And this gives me a new principled BSDF shader. And while I'm here, I'll change to EEVEE. And I'm going to turn on a few things. Screen space reflections, turn off half res trace, turn on bloom, because I don't know, why not? And maybe motion blur. And that should be pretty good for this. And now I'm gonna go to world and I'm going to turn the color all the way down to black. And now I'm gonna add a light in. So you can see here that I deleted the light, the default light that's not in here. So I'm gonna go to add light and I'll say area, and I'll throw the area up above, and I could say maybe soften it a little bit. The larger the area gets, the softer the light gets. So the larger the light source, the softer it is. And power about 150. That looks pretty good. And so now I have that, and that's looking pretty decent. So I can now go ahead and make the shader. So for this guy, base color, let's see, I'll make a kind of a yellowish color. I'll turn it to metallic, and roughness, make it pretty rough so it's like shiny and cool. And that works kind of golden. And now I can just select the rest of these and just make these like that. That will work pretty well. So there we go. So now what I can do is I can just change this this bottom here. So I'll hit new, give that a new shader. And I think what I'll do is I'll just kind of make this, let me see, what happens if I make this metallic and rough? Ooh yeah, there we go. Getting enough nice rough shader in there. And what I can do is I can like make it so it's not like perfectly See how like this is like perfectly reflective? I can change that by going add, texture, I'll say Musgrave, okay? And then I'll do add, converter, color ramp, and I'll take the factor of Musgrave, turn it, plug it into the factor of color ramp, and then color to, color to roughness here. And what I can do now is that black will be completely shiny and white will be rough. And this kind of brings in this rough areas, these rough areas here, see that? So I'll scale this up a little bit and kind of make just some breakage here. Detail, lacunarity, dimension, split it up a bit. And then this is obviously like way too crazy here. So I can flip this by just hitting this little arrow thing and saying flip color ramp. And just kind of bring it in. And then maybe take this and maybe push that up a little bit. And base color, I can change to something a little more interesting. And then FBM here, I can change. I just get something interesting. I mean, this is up to you, really. You just whatever you want. That's fine. And now, one other thing we can do here is I can go and turn on the bloom a little bit more. And then we'll get to our logo animation, which is probably what you've been waiting for. Okay, so let's go ahead and go to EEVEE, go to Bloom, maybe make this, it's way too hot. There we go, 0.2, that's probably pretty good. So now what we can do is do the animation. So we have this going, that's looking pretty cool. Now let's animate the wireframe. So to do that, I'm gonna hit this. And what I'll do is I'll go to this object data, and I'll turn the preview resolution up, and that's just gonna make this cooler across the board. So I'll do that for each one of these as I go. But what I'm gonna do now is I'm going to say end, start and end. See that? It fills it in. It kind of like traces it. So what I'll do is at frame, let's just say I start at frame 24, that's 1 second in. I'm going to go to end, and I'm going to hit insert keyframe. And then at about 20 frames out, I'm going to hit it one. And then the next one here, same thing. So I'll go to 30, turn that down, insert keyframe, go to 50, turn it up, keyframe. 40 for the next one, turn this down, keyframe, 60, up to one, keyframe. And the last one, 50, these are just so they overlap as they're animating. 0, okay, keyframe, and then 70, up to one, keyframe. So now, if you look at this and I hit play, you can see it fills in. Pretty nice, right? That's pretty cool. And lastly, what we can do here is I can kind of make it blink out at the end here. So what I can do with that is I can go ahead and add in texture and a control to this base color. So this is kind of cool like this, but I can add some variation by doing something really interesting here. I can do add, converter, color ramp. I can drop this onto this and drop this onto this. Okay, just clicking and dragging, all right, left click and drag. And then I can change the color to maybe something a little more red. And now I color to base color here, and it'll change it, but it's not really changing, it's just kind of giving me a gradient. So what I can do here is go to input, and I can say object info, and I can take random, plug random into factor here. And now if I change RGB to like HSV and change this to like far, I could really kind of like get random colors here, but that's not what I want. I don't want the rainbow effect. So I'll just keep near here, and I can just go ahead and that'll just give me some slight variation here. So you can change that to constant and you can see what that's doing. And if you added more colors in here, like, it would totally do that. But I'll just leave it at HSV, and then it'll just kind of randomize the colors just enough so they're a little more interesting to me. And if I hit play, here we go. Nice. So what I'll do here is I'll make it blink out at the end. So to do that, I'll go to like 130. And now Colorramp here, what I can do is I can add in, so Shift A or go to add, doesn't matter. And I'm gonna go to color and I'll say brightness and contrast, throw that in, and now I have a brightness control. All right, that's wild. So what I'll do is I'll go to zero, and at 130 I'll keyframe it. So I right click on bright, insert keyframe. Then maybe at 131, I can bump it up a little bit, insert keyframe. Then at 132, I can go negative, insert keyframe. Okay, bring it back up to zero, insert keyframe. Go a couple out, go brightness, insert keyframe. Next one, go dark, insert keyframe. And then maybe toward the end, I can like make it really bright where it just whites out the whole thing. Insert keyframe. So now if I hit play, and maybe I can go like a little bit before that too. So I could start at like 120. Insert keyframe here. Darken it out. Insert keyframe. Go a few more. Brighten it up. Insert keyframe. Dark. Insert keyframe. Light. Insert keyframe. And you see here. Boom. So let's give this a render and see what it looks like. So to do that, I'm simply going to go to output. Okay, I created a folder called wire logo. I'll just call it wirelogo.mp4 for this one. Hit accept. Go here to file format, FFmpeg, encoding, HT64 in MP4. And everything else looks all right. I think I'm okay with everything else. So I will hit render animation, and see that? That's bad. So one last thing I have to do here is I can turn these off, or I don't really need them anymore. So in my case right now, I'll just delete them. And now I'll hit render animation, and there we go. So let me pause it and come back. Okay, so we're back and here we are with the logo. And it's looking pretty interesting. I'm kind of digging it. So you can go ahead and change up, you know, play with it, change the floor if you want, the color, things that, you know, could have been a little bit cleaner in this video or whatever. But yeah, that's the general idea of making this kind of effect. And it's kind of fun. And you can go ahead and play with it and see what you can do. So with that, hopefully you got something out of this video. If you did, hit like, subscribe, share it, and I'll just keep making more. So I'll see you in the next video. Thanks. Bye.